taking a bit further on your comment on the choice, the two choices, because funnily enough, I was going to, I've been preparing a discussion, there's a debate on this issue of enhancement. And I'm wondering, one of the things I wanted to find out was, why is it that although I have no religion, I don't believe in using artificial means of enhancement. I have some kind of resistance. Now, what I'm wondering is this because of some atavistic kind of supernatural thing lurking in, you know, in my upbringing that's led me to believe that there should be no pain, no gain without pain, or are there some other reasons? Because I find it very difficult to make the stark choice between the two. I mean, I think there are a lot of political implications in the transhuman endeavour, particularly less so perhaps in medicine, but perhaps in things like enhancement of intelligence and so on, because it's been argued that we could end up with a very tiered society in which those who could afford it would get the super intelligence and things, and we'd end up with a subhuman society. You know, it's the sort of Brave New World idea. So I'd like some comments on that, please.
Hi. I think David Chalmers probably champions, I think, I've not read much of his work, but I think he might champion panpsychism as an explanation for consciousness. That is to say that everything has a phenomenological aspect. I find that quite an attractive proposition because it seems to be the simplest, and it seems to get rid of any problems which arise from needing to say, right, there's a higher order process which gives rise to some kind of possibly illusory sense of self and this phenomenal aspect. I think panpsychism says that that's implicit in the universe as much as matter is. I find that very attractive. And I'm wondering what the panel thinks about that.
Yes, the title on the screen is Darwinian Thought and Theories of Human Nature. My question to the panel is that we've had 2,000 years at least of philosophy. We've had great advances, technical advances. We've had a great number of medical advances. But is there any evidence that human nature has actually changed in the last 2,000 years? And is it likely to change in the future, when you take into account what man does to man today? There's some terrible examples, of course, Darfur and other areas of the world. Have there been any advances at all in human nature over the last 2,000 years?
Thank you. And pick one more, can we step in there?
Well, my comment relates to what Bruce Charlton had to say, and I feel in the light of his conclusions particularly that it may be premature to put so much reliance on coherence in a very complex world. And I must say I'm particularly inclined to say this after having spent a day with Dave Pierce, whom Bruce extolled as the only coherent person he'd ever met, who I must say is the weirdest guy I have ever met as well, although a very nice person, of course, in his very weird way. I just can't believe that being like Dave Pierce or being a Mormon are the only coherent options for humanity.